one more time behind me. I'm hoping that my glasses are clean. To you, Immerman, to the trustees, Dean Roderick, Mayor, Lord, Chairman of the Trustees, to the council, to the faculty, the staff, the families and the graduated class, fans and supporters of Montserrat College, thank you, you all. To the graduating class of 2017, congratulations. Today, you celebrate the culmination of a remarkable journey. Together with your faculty, your parents, and your peers today, as well today, you enter an extraordinary new chapter of your life that will put to test the strength of what you learned here. I am taken over by emotion, and I am immensely, immensely humbled and proud by the trust and honor that you are bestowing upon me, with the honorary Lord to the Dean. Indeed, overwhelmed by joy and sense of responsibility, as you have invited me to come today into your house and share souls, reflection, and salutation to the graduating class. I accept your honorary degree not only in my name, but in and with the support of my ancestors, and particularly the women in my family that let me believe as a very young age that the road ahead of me was open as wide as the span of my own aspirations. In the presence of family here today with me, my husband, my aunt, my cousins, and friends, I thank them too, as they have been pillars that sustain my life and my dreams over the years. At this moment, as you offer to me an opportunity to retrace my own journey to this podium, I could see myself leaving my hometown at a very early age, as a small lady with a wooden suitcase in hands, waiting at a dusty road for the bus in the way to the art school, 4 hours away. Just determined, as you are today, to find the tools that will allow me to give material meaning to the contents of my inner soul. From that vantage viewpoint of the moment when I leave the small village of La Vega, in the municipality of Manguito, in the region of Colón, in the province of Matanzas, the so-called Athens of Cuba, the soul that maybe one day I will be in a Beverly, Massachusetts, on a Friday morning, addressing the graduating class of 2017, could be seen as a stuff of fantasy and fairy tales. But yes, here I am, as a testimony of how far one could travel with just dreams. From here, as I look at you all, there is an aura, there is an illuminated energy emanating from you and every one of you. And I can see it. As I am celebrating you, I just realize how many impossible dreams have turned into reality under my eyes, so will be yours. You, as I have done, will cross vast distance geographically and in the imagination. Graduating class, for a minute, for a second, join me in a small performance piece. Please stand up and look at your palms of your hands. Every one of you, look at the palms of your hands. Observe the palms of your hands. Notice that they are maps, roads, rivers, long and short crossing lines, detours, encounters, erasures. But most important, all of them are inscribed in the firm ground of your hands, your tools for transformations, the producers of miracles, those visions. As you exercise perseverance and determination, commitment, is your style aligned with your vision and deep honesty with your convictions and what resonates deep within you, your most hidden inner souls and ambitions could become real with the help of those hands. Look at each of them. You will learn from your road you travel, from the encounters in your journey, and you will turn the detours in learning moments. Like a good drawing, let the lines navigate it from your brain now to your heart, to your guts, to your hands, and imagine that be and become the materialities of your dreams. Only you could make that happen. Please sit down.